sorry to disturb you, Albus, but I've just received troubling news.
Tell me, what is it?
It's Grindelwald.
It's such a pleasure to speak to the both of you, and I'll start with you, Mads. And your first day on set, I mean, it must have been so exciting to dive into the Fantastic Beasts world. Yes. Do you remember your first day on set and how it felt?
I believe that's the scene where I enter a room this size and the music stops and everybody turns their head.
German Ministry of Magic.
Yeah. And that's exactly how it felt. I was obviously the odd guy in the room. And it was beautiful. It worked out fine. It was a great day. I mean, I was just hoping that the family would adopt me, and they all did. So I couldn't ask for anything else.
Mr. Kowalski, we need you.
I said I wanted out and I want out.
Ah! You do know I'm a witch, right?
Well, she's really cool too. I mean, as a character, it must have been amazing to, you know, develop her as a very decisive kind of, you know, a person that knows exactly what she's doing. I mean, she treads the world with confidence. I love that.
Yeah, I like playing strong characters and I like playing strong women. And I was really excited to kind of step into Lally's world. She's a professor of charms at Ilvermorny, the North American Wizarding School. And so I was really excited to walk into this world with confidence, even though, like, similar to Mads, I was dropped into this sort of big, beautiful, detailed world. And everyone was really lovely.
The time is close, my brothers and sisters.
Our war with the Muggles begins today!
What would you say was your main point of research for Grindelwald, especially with the way you wanted to play him and your version of him?
I mean, obviously, I watched the films, spoke a lot with David, spent quite a bit of time with Jude, because my character is very much connected to his character. So that was my preparation, not unlike other films. The big difference was, obviously, it's been done before me, so we needed a bridge between what I did and Johnny did, and made it our own. That was the key to the whole thing. In trying to copy him would be created suicide, and what he did was amazing, so we had to do something else.
What you're doing is madness. With or without you, I'll burn down their world.
It's a real ensemble, and it's always an ensemble in Harry Potter and Fantastic Beasts, but in this one they're very interconnected, like you mentioned, you know, with the Dumbledore character. Did it translate into, you know, a lot of camaraderie on set, you know? Did it feel, was there this positive atmosphere of a family?
Definitely. I mean, we were lucky enough to be able to shoot it during the pandemic, so we were all working, and it was a different time.
And you couldn't go anywhere. No one can go anywhere else.
Yeah, we couldn't go anywhere. We couldn't really go out because at the time there wasn't any vaccines or anything. It did create sort of this sense of camaraderie that we were all in this really interesting filming situation together, because it was very strange.
But it is a strong family sense. I mean, they've been doing it for a few years now. But it was funny because everybody knew each other crisscross, but we realized late that, oh, this is actually the first scene I have with this person, because we've been seeing each other up and down the corridors, right? But as a character, it's a different thing when you enter the room. So that was fun.
Do you really intend to turn your back on your own kind? It was you who said we could reshape the world.
Even if we make mistakes.
You know, are there pinch-me moments on Harry Potter sets, even for seasoned actors like yourself?
Just non-stop. I mean, everything. I mean, the crew is so talented. Like, even just the patina, like, on this room and how old it feels. I was always in awe. And then you realize, oh, right, I have lines and I need to learn them and I need to make sure that I know what's going on.
I'm here to work.
Yeah, I mean, there's just no way you convince me that this is a set. I mean, you can walk all the way up and touch it, and there's no way you can tell me it's a set. It's amazing.
There's nothing you can do to stop me.
Yeah, because there's also, you know, the attention to detail. I think every room has, you know, the box around the corner has something that's put in there for a right reason.
But her world is also so detailed, right? Mm-hmm. So bringing that to life is an achievement of itself. But I can't. There's nothing coming to mind where a world has been, you know, portrayed that detailed as her world. It's just enormous.
We're going to need some help.
And finally, what are you most looking forward for fans to see?
it's out of our hands, right? I'm looking forward for my kids to see the film. I just want to see their faces, mm-hmm. right? Because it's a different thing. Normally, when you come home and say, I'm starting this new job, their question is, so how long are you going to be gone? But it was a different thing with this.
I can imagine.
What if I said I'm also looking forward to Matt's kids seeing the film as well? Because they sound really sweet. I am excited about people seeing really cool defensive magic, like really cool adult magic. There's just some really cool fight sequences in this film that I think are really strong and good. And I want people to go have fun when they see it.
I think they will. I've seen it.
Great. Awesome.
Thank you so much, you guys. Appreciate it. Great talking to you. Have a lovely day.
Things are not quite what they appear.